Hello, and welcome to worship at Trinity United Church in Winnipeg for Sunday, May 8th. We are pleased that you have found our location for the online service as we worship together. Wherever you are, we are gathered as a virtual congregation in this place, and we embrace your presence as part of our community of faith. Our minister, Reverend Elizabeth Brown, is on sabbatical for 3 months. We send greetings to her and wish her success in her activities. Reverend Paul DuVal provides spiritual leadership to the Trinity family during the sabbatical time. It's my great pleasure to introduce Reverend Paul to you and to welcome him to the leadership of today's service. Paul, we're pleased to have you with us and look forward to your message today.
Thank you very much. Thanks very much, Harry, and it's a pleasure to be with you all here at Trinity. As we begin the service today, we acknowledge with gratitude the traditional territories of our Indigenous and Métis neighbors and their hospitality. We offer our respect and commitment to living into right relationship with all our relations. There are a few announcements that we want to begin with. One is an upcoming food blitz for the West Broadway Community Ministry during the month of May. We're collecting canned vegetables, soups, meats, fish, cereal. Check with the email announcements for more details and bring your donations here to the church. The second one is spring cleanup, May 14th at 9 o'clock, a time to gather in the church with mops, buckets, sponges, and to, as a community, do a spring refit, a spring renovation. So please write that in your calendar. And as we begin, the light of Christ glows in our midst. And from the Christ candle, we light the affirming candle as a sign that we are an open community, welcoming of all who gather here in this place. Our music today is courtesy of Bert Johnson and the Trinity Choir, and we'll begin with our call to worship, God of the Bible. More Voices, number 28.
Status, those who are nothing, you have made royal, gifted with rights, chosen as partners, midwives of justice, birthing new systems, lighting new lights, fresh as the morning, sure as the sunrise, God always faithful, you do not change, fresh as the morning, sure as the sunrise, God always faithful, you do not change.
For those of us who are Christians living in the Northern Hemisphere, the time after Easter is part of the coming of spring for us, heralding new opportunities, new delights, and new joy. This year, spring has taken its time showing up. But finally, It's looking like it may be truly, unmistakably, irrevocably here. I want to remind those of you who are participating with us online that we will be celebrating the Sacrament of Communion a little later, and this might be a good time to pause the video and make sure you are prepared with a glass of juice and a piece of bread or cracker for when the time comes. Let us pray. Creator, we give thanks for this new day, a time to open ourselves to newness and possibility. We give thanks for this community where we are nurtured and share our stories of faith and life. In this moment, surround us with your Spirit. Fill our hearts and hear our prayers. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. And now I'd like to invite our reader, Carolyn Pearson, to share the scripture today.
Scripture is our song for the journey, the living word passed on from generation to generation to guide and inspire. Today's reading is from the New International Version Study Bible, Psalm 23, a Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May God bless to our understanding this reading from the Holy Scriptures.
Good morning. As Harry said, my name is Paul DuVal, and I will be working with Trinity United Church for the next 3 months while Elizabeth is on sabbatical. Someone may have said I was filling in for Elizabeth, which is not quite an accurate description, as if the guy who has only used the photocopier once and has trouble remembering his PIN for the alarm system and has only met a handful of people could fill in for all the many things that Elizabeth does with her considerable skill and energy. But here we are, and we'll continue. Some 30 years ago, an author working with the Alban Institute, then a prominent church resource and consulting agency, coined the phrase temporary shepherds in relation to ministers that are filling in, have a limited tenure with a particular congregation. So perhaps that's a good description of what I am, a temporary shepherd. I must admit, though, that I have always felt uncomfortable about the association of ministry with shepherding. It seems too much like a one-sided relationship, and it seems to place too much authority on the clergy and to invest too little agency in the laity. I think I've usually learned much more from congregations than I have taught. And then, as it dawned on me quite late that this Sunday was Mother's Day, I forgot to ask if there are any special traditions that Trinity observes on this particular Sunday. Of course, COVID has changed all our traditions and our ability to mark them. But to you who are able to celebrate today with your mothers, bless you. To you who are not able to be with your mother today or are remembering mothers who have died, I join you. And if today is a little raw because you are remembering a mother who died recently during COVID, I hope that the remembering itself will offer you a little comfort and healing. Many congregations recently have taken to marking this day as Christian Family Sunday. It's a way of acknowledging that nurturing can come from many places. Fathers nurture. Grandparents nurture. Aunts nurture. Special friends have roles in nurturing. And today we affirm that all children, and all adults for that matter, need love and care, and it comes from many places. Psalm 23, the Shepherd Psalm, is perhaps the best known and most loved of the Hebrew Scriptures. It's a personal and corporate affirmation that at its core, life is good. The universe can be trusted. That God guides us throughout our lives. Phrases stand out. I shall not want. Restores my soul. Leads me in paths of righteousness. After a long winter and over 2 years coping with COVID, and it's not over for those who are living with flooding, we need a little restoration, a little green grass, a little still water. And today, the ultimate expression of family, of community, you prepare a table before me. We share a meal together in memory of Jesus, in the presence of other disciples, a sign of goodness and grace. As we enter spring and we begin this time together, let us feast and be glad. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let's join and sing from Voices United, hymn number 670, Precious Lord, Take My Hand. Given in a wide variety of ways and used for the purposes of the church and in the service of the community.
O God, we offer you praise and gratitude for the creation in which we live, for the lives we are privileged to lead, and for the challenges offered to us.
We're thankful for those who accompany us on our life journey. Springtime is awakening us to the joys of renewed life as the deep valley of winter is lifted from us. We give thanks that we can plant those tiny seeds with new hope and have them grow into the abundance of harvest, all within the coming season. We give thanks for those whom you have chosen to lead us in our spiritual journey. We welcome Reverend Paul DuVal to our ministry. We ask for your guidance to Elizabeth as she rests and studies, and we give thanks for Irma and Jennifer who lead us in the needs of this community of faith. We have heard the metaphor of the shepherd who leads the flock in our scripture reading this morning. We rejoice that the ancient peoples represented in the Psalms saw the value of the native animals in their area and domesticated sheep, as well as the wild grains that you had placed in their midst. We rejoice that the metaphor of the shepherd extended to the presence of Jesus among us, and whom you provided to walk with us and to dwell in us as we seek paths of righteousness. We do indeed encounter the darkest of valleys. We think of those in our community of faith and in our extended families who are disadvantaged, those who encounter illness, and those who are distressed. We remember each of these persons in our prayers and seek their anointment with comfort. Among the dark valleys we encounter is the continuing presence of the COVID virus. The tools of vaccinations, health worker care, and simple measures each of us can employ are the metaphoric rod and staff by which we are comforted and led through the valley. The senseless war in Ukraine, characterized by biological attacks on innocent people, entrenchment of ideological objectives, and much extensive suffering, is a deep, dark valley in our experience. We ask that rationality will prevail and goodwill will be restored so that aggressors and those subject to aggression may dwell in a new condition as people of the earth who share a common destiny and heritage. We ask for your wisdom to be extended to our political leaders, that they may choose wisely the way suffering can be relieved and the way in which the thinking can be changed of those who are at the root of the suffering. These things we bring before you, God, knowing that as we place ourselves in your care, you will lead us along the path and challenge us to go into the world sharing the good news of the gospel. May we go forth as we leave this, our spiritual home, with our thirst quenched, and with the commission to act. And as we do, we are guided by the prayer that Jesus left with us, that is led for us by our spiritual leader, Paul.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This is the table of our Lord Jesus Christ. All are welcome to come and partake of this holy meal. Let us join in prayer. God is with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift our hearts to God. Let us give praise to God. It is good to praise and thank you, God. Thanks and praise be to you, gracious God, worker of wonders, maker of miracles, author of all life, and giver of all delight. Out of chaos and fear, you bring beauty and hope. Out of despair and death, you create courage and new life. And so, in the name of the risen Christ, who makes all things new by the power of his resurrection, we gather to celebrate gifts of memory, gifts of hope, gifts of community. We remember that on the night before he died, Jesus, at supper with his friends, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he passed it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is the bread of life. Whenever you do this, remember me." After supper, Jesus also took the cup of wine. He said the blessing, and he passed it to his friends, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is the cup of blessing. Whenever you do this, remember me." Creator God, as spring breaks forth in our midst and life blossoms around us, we pray for your spirit and your blessing on us and on these gifts that we share, that all who gather at this holy table may be one body, one people, united in the mission to share love and grace with each other and with the world. Recalling his death, proclaiming his resurrection, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you, God, this bread and this cup. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts, that all who drink at this table may be one body, one holy people, a living sacrifice in Christ Jesus our Lord. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come, all is now prepared. This is the bread of life. Amen. This is the cup of blessing. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, may we be nourished and strengthened by the blessing of this bread and this cup, and by the community with whom we share. May we tell our stories and live with courage and go into the world with joy and wonder to share grace and love wherever we go. Amen. Our closing hymn today is from Voices United, number 382, "Breathe on Me, Breath of God."
That I may love one.
And now may grace and peace go with us all, today and every day. Amen.